have this chance to recognize their accomplishments and their lives in this special service of worship. And you'll be hearing from them very shortly. So welcome to all, and welcome to our confirmands. Welcome to new visitors and old friends. Welcome to all who are seeking a church home, who need strength, and who want to follow in the ways of love. Welcome to old and young, to believers and questioners, and questioning believers. Whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you find yourself on life's journey, you are welcome here. Well, before our announcements, and I think we have a few, I would ask that you please fill out the welcome pads, which are towards the center aisle, and take a look at the names of those you'll be worshiping with so that you might greet them after the service. Would you like to start us off, Christine?
Good morning. On behalf of the Board of Missions, I want to draw your attention to the coat collection drive that's mentioned in the bulletin. We're collecting coats in the narthex. I see some people have brought some already. They will be distributed at St. Paul's United Methodist Church the day after Thanksgiving, and then throughout the winter as needed. So whatever you can bring will be helpful to clothe the people in need in Newport. Thank you.
Good morning. I just want to thank the people that helped with the soup kitchen. If you baked, if you showed up to help, if you brought bananas here, there were a few missteps, but we got through it and it was fine. The largest of which was it wasn't cooked in time, but we got through it.
Good morning. Just a couple of quick ones. This day really does belong to the confirmands. This is a clipboard. Perhaps we're not familiar with it. Okay. We'd love to see your name on it. And we'd love to see you at the luncheon next Sunday. It's potluck. Please bring something simple to share, like a platter of sandwiches, chips or dip, salad, cookies, brownies, and please come to enjoy a casual meal after worship. Now, something that many of you have been wondering, where are we in the pledge campaign? Okay. So that, in case you're way in the back, this is 137,448. If you've already made your pledge, thank you very much. Our goal this year is 216,000. This figure represents almost 64% of our goal. This is the most recent total I have for pledges. There are a few more to be added. This is a good start. It does show progress, but we really do need to go a little further. Please keep the needs of the church in mind when completing your pledge card and help us realize our bright future. Thank you very much.
Hello, it's about the bazaar again. Couple quick things. The jewelry box will be out next to, on the table next to Derek's. The sooner you bring in your jewelry donations, the better for me, because I, you know, clean and package it. Also, I have these color copies. Kudos to Cindy Perry for posting this on her Facebook. I would like everyone to take a copy and post on their Facebook, and then post it at your work and keep reposting it. I'd appreciate it. Thank you. Bye.
Loving God, we are grateful for our lives and for this opportunity to celebrate with you the lives of our young people. We need you because there's so much in this world that is challenging, and we have two loved ones that have been lifted up and are in need of your care. Guide the doctors and nurses and all those who have surrounded them, that they may know that they are loved and that your presence will bring healing. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. I'd like to invite Patty forward for the introduction of our confirmants.
Come on up. Those who participated in a confirmation journey this year, come on up and stand alphabetical. One of the things that we taught this year in Journey was what it means to be part of a community of faith. And this is exactly what it means today, to lift others in prayer and hold them with love.
Come in the middle.
We're warming up for the rest of the service, so. Take a good look at these amazing, amazing people. Oh, it has been wonderful. I know many of you have had different experiences with confirmation, and you know that confirmation has changed over the years, depending on the time and place and the Christian tradition, will determine the confirmation journey. And this year at United, we specifically designed our confirmation journey to meet the needs of today's youth and respond to the Christian landscape that is here in our community, and using a holistic community of faith approach, fostering a sense of belonging, a sense of wonder, providing a safe space to explore holy questions and doubt and seek, and cultivating our identity and self and our community connections with you, our outside community, and connections with God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit. Confirmation is not a test. It is not a requirement. It is not a graduation from Sunday school. What it is the beginning of a lifelong journey of faith, whether one chooses to be confirmed or not, to confirm their baptism at the end or not. It's an amazing experience. And these amazing young people before you committed to this journey, to be part of the journey, and they helped design the experience. They chose the holy questions. They chose when we were going to meet. We communicated if we had some conflict and dates weren't working out. And it all came together. We decided how we were going to explore the holy questions, and Jonathan and I were just the spiritual guides leading them along the way. The journey included connecting with each other, with their church life, with the wider community, with the mentor, and like I said, with God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. A supportive community of faith is essential in the confirmation journey. And I want to applaud you. Thank you, our parents, our mentors, our wider community partners, and our congregation. Thank you for making this an amazing journey and holding these young folks in your hearts and helping them and guiding them and continuing to be a community to them and teaching them they are loved by God and supported their whole self. So I'd like to lift up an applause for all of you and particularly our young folks. Thank you. Go back to your seats and we'll call you back up. And you'll hear more about their faith stories. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for the opening hymn.
Thank you.
gather together to hear stories of faith and courage. Listen for the ways God has acted among us.
Our ancestors in the faith listened for God's word. They dared to believe God's promises.
Leaders like Moses and Paul saw evidence of God's work. They believed they were face to face with God's truth.
They looked beyond the present moment. They lived for dreams not yet realized.
Many felt God's love in knowing Jesus. They experienced a new relationship with neighbors.
We are a constituting community centered in Christ. We want to feel God's presence as we worship.
Let us lift our voices in unison for our prayer of invocation. God, you have been our dwelling place in all generations, before the earth was formed, long before there were people on this planet. You were fashioning life in its myriad forms. Out of the billions of years you have been creating, our lives have come to this moment of meeting. We stand in awe before you, amazed to discover that you care about us, tiny blips on the ocean of eternity. Oh God, we want our lives to count for something. Show us how to fit into your plans. Amen.
Let us join our hearts in prayer. Eternal God, whose wisdom defies our limited insights and whose commandments are from everlasting to everlasting, open our hearts and souls and minds to your love that surrounds us and seeks a dwelling place in us, that we may regard ourselves as your valuable children and accord the same care and concern to others as we would, at our best, lavish on ourselves. May our lives honor you and display the power of your love to the world. Speak to us now through the mystery of your holy word. Amen. The readings today are from Psalm 139, 1 through 6, and 13 through 18. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit up and when I rise, when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all of my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderfully are your works that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my uniform substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. I am still with you. This is the word of the Lord. And the second reading is from Matthew 22, 34 through 40. When the Pharisees heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. Teacher, which commandment is the law? In the law is the greatest? He said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the laws and the prophets. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, O Christ.
Thank you, Chloe. Thank you, Chancel. That was wonderful. Wonderful to have you back. Now we come to the part of the rite of confirmation. And here at United, part of this year's journey, we're including faith stories, a proclamation of our faith. To be a witness of our faith is a Christian tradition, telling stories of our faith. The last few years, we've had opportunities to share stories during our Vespers, how the natural elements touch our lives and connect us to the divine. We've told stories here in worship in our sanctuary. And today we'll hear from our young friends, our older youth, and they'll be sharing their faith stories. And faith stories is a way for us to continue to tell God's story. And many vibrant churches are using this as a way to grow in size and to grow deeper in faith. And the faith stories are considered an offering, so I encourage us to hold our applause until they're all done. I know we're going to feel like applauding them, but with this, let's hold off until all of them have told their story.
During our time together, I mentioned to our young people that if they had questions of faith, if they were wrestling with some of the bigger issues that we have discussed, when they come into this room, they'll have good company. That is the faith journey. It's not something that you have all set, a complete package. It's a lifelong journey. And so I was so pleased when Patty and I joined some of our older youth, our adults, on the spiritual retreat last weekend, because there's no greater model that we as adults can provide for our young people than through our actions and our willingness to walk this journey with integrity and with a willingness and an open heart to examine the questions that we carry here. So thank you for being that model, for providing the direction for our young people as they continue their journey.
At this time, I invite the first three faith story proclaimers and their mentors to come on up.
That song always stirs me. Well, it's my pleasure to introduce a remarkable young man and share a message of his faith journey, Mr. Luke West.
I grew up in a family where spirituality was very important. As I grew older, I began questioning and exploring my own beliefs. Through various experiences and encounters, I found comfort and guidance in my faith, which has helped shape who I am today. Ever since I can remember, I've always been interested in animals and drawn to by nature. By the time I was 8, I had 3 lizards, a hedgehog, 3 chickens, 2 fish tanks, and a dog happy. Thanks, Grandma. I guess that you can say that I feel closest to God when I'm caring for animals and in nature. I also enjoy fishing and cruising on our boat. I sometimes take our boat out by myself and explore the Skana and Narragansett Bay. I feel a sense of peace when I'm on the water. Through my confirmation journey, I've learned how I can individually connect with God in places where I feel most spiritually connected. There have been times in my life that have been challenging, and during these times, my faith is my source of strength. I am thankful I have my faith. As I grow older, so does my awareness and desire to hold on to my faith in God. Thank you.
Elena Sun, remarkable young woman, perceptive, intelligent, thoughtful. She already speaks 3 languages, and she's learning a 4th at Portsmouth High School. She is taking 3 AP courses. She's a member of student council. I went to one of her soccer games, and she is good. We've had some interesting discussions. Goals for the future, she has very clear goals. She has a solid base in her faith. She wants to study medicine and she wants to be a radiologist. She's destined for great things. I have no doubt that God will guide her in all that her future brings. Elena.
Good morning, everyone. I started my faith journey when I was baptized in a Lutheran church in San Diego, California. I don't remember much, but the highlight was definitely getting to play the Star of Bethlehem in our preschool show. After we moved to Cape Cod, my family went to a congregational church in Falmouth, and once we were in Portsmouth, we started coming to this church. Especially here, my favorite ways to participate in worship are listening to the congregation sing hymns and filling the whole sanctuary with their faith. When I joined confirmation class, there were big question marks surrounding my faith. Others always seemed so confident and sure of what they believed in, and they seemed to know everything and never had any doubts. But for me, I struggled with what my faith was and what it meant to be ready to affirm my faith. Especially as Confirmation Sunday came closer and closer, I kept asking myself, how do I know I'm good enough to follow God? I even considered getting confirmed later once I was ready, but I was still left with the question of, what does ready even mean? I kept finding more and more questions, but could only find uncertain answers. I felt like I would never be ready for such a big decision and that I could never fulfill my promises after confirmation. One of my biggest obstacles was feeling like I didn't know much about God's presence in my life and not being sure how to be confirmed if my connection to God was so limited. However, my mentors, Miss Jean and Miss Pam, have helped me to know God's presence a lot more. From my mentors, I've learned not only about people in my congregation, but also their faith-given strength. I've learned a lot about new perspectives on God and life, helping me to expand my understanding of what feeling God can be like. They've helped me realize that though I may not have experienced something where I've clearly needed God or felt his guidance, confirmation is just another part of my journey where I'm setting the foundation for when I need God in the future. My mentors have helped me remember that everyone is at a different point on their faith journey, and that made me realize that being confirmed today is about promising to God that I'm willing to learn and follow his teachings. It means that it's okay that I'm not entirely sure about my relationship with God. Instead, being unsure and having more questions will only allow my faith to grow and change as I change as a person. My faith does not end here, and I know it'll continue to grow as I learn new things about myself and God's world.
I'd like to introduce to you Kyle Kidd. He's grown up in this church, so many of you know him. Our families are close friends, but you know, in the course of doing that, like sometimes you don't really get to know somebody as they grow up, right? And so I know a few things about him now that I didn't to start with. I mean, I knew he comes across as a quiet, unassuming, polite young man. Probably a fierce enforcer on the hockey ice at night. You know, one of the things that I've learned over sort of the long walks that he seems to enjoy is, you know, he's surprised me with, you know, how uncommonly thoughtful and considerate and mature he is as a young man. And so it's my, you know, privilege to introduce him to you, Kyle.
Thank you. Good morning. And I should be honest, when I was like thinking about what to write, I got a little stuck. But then on the sheet that Patty gave us to sort of get us thinking about what to write, I saw the question, like, when was the time that faith may have touched your life? And well, there was definitely a time when God may have touched my life, because you see, when I was really young, like 3, I was diagnosed with epilepsy. And I wouldn't respond to any of the medications. And in fact, one medicine was a trigger for me, and it's actually still my only allergy. But anyways, through the careful application of the ketogenic diet by my mom, who is a registered dietitian, and help from people at Boston Children's Hospital, I was able to overcome it. And I actually really want to thank my mom, because she had to do this all through my sister being born, my dad being deployed, and us moving to Rhode Island. But anyways, I haven't had a seizure since February 2011. And I barely remember this period in my life, thankfully, probably, but my parents say that it was God that saved me from my epilepsy. And I'm not sure that it was, but if it was, then I'd like to thank him for giving me a chance at a normal life. I'm able to play contact sports, like hockey, and do well in school. And yeah, and so I want to make the most out of this gift, and I want to live a life that makes other people's lives better as well as enjoying mine. And all in all, I don't want my life to go to waste, especially if there's a chance I wouldn't be up here today, especially in this condition. So thank you.
To introduce Ben West. I have known him his whole life as his grandmother. He turned 17 on Friday. Ben is a scholar athlete. He's an excellent student. He's a great hockey teammate, and I love to watch him on the ice. But Ben is also kind, considerate, and respectful. I have a text thread on my phone, and it's called The Muscle. And when I send a text, instantly Ben Luke, and Kyle all show up at our house and do whatever we ask, weeding, moving furniture, carrying things around, and we are great, are very happy about it. I'm grateful to have Ben in our family and in this church community.
Thank you. Good morning, and thank you all for being here on this special day for our class of confirmands. Although we may not feel it all the time, God has a presence in everyone's lives. Our confirmation class has done two main action projects, which included serving food to those in need in Newport and going up to Boston and doing art with those who are less fortunate. Both of these activities, I felt God's presence, but most of all, when we served food to people in Newport. While the Boston trip was amazing and getting to see that church and interact with people, the Newport one stood out. Serving food in Newport, helping set up and seeing all these people be so grateful for what seems like just a simple meal was truly an amazing experience. And that it would be hard not to feel God's presence while doing that. Also, I would like to add that when I was baby Jesus at this very church, I would have felt God's presence if I was able to think at that age. So far in my life, I'm extremely fortunate to be able to say that many people have my back. I'm able to stop and take a second to think about many people in my life, which range from family, friends, teammates, to people at school. First of all, obviously my amazing parents have my back and always would no matter what. They are with me through thick and thin. Last school year, I might have gotten pretty big trouble at school, and my parents were able to support me also while pushing the correct amount of punishment and teaching on me. Because of this, now I'm able to look back on this and learn from it. On the brighter side, they're also always with me through the good times, like making the high school hockey championship, and don't ask me if we won. I would like to finish with the thank yous. I'd like to thank my mama, my grandmother, who also served as my mentor, for supporting me along this journey. I'd like to thank Pastor Jonathan for being at so many meetings and providing his wise and meaningful view on things we learned. And most of all, I'd like to thank Miss Patty for being an amazing leader and teacher and providing and improving the overall experience of getting confirmed. There was never a meeting when you weren't excited to accomplish our goals for the day and your energy would spread to the entire class. Your flexibility with the schedule was always so helpful, fitting in school, homework, and hockey was never easy. And we may or may not be running off to a hockey game after this. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Debbie Birdie, and I'm Hannah's grandmother. And Susan and Murphy and I had the privilege of being her sponsor mentor. I have to say, when Hannah was baptized here, you, the congregation, made a promise that you would be there for her faith formation, and you have been. She's attended the Sunday school. She's helped with the coffee hour. She's helped with the soup kitchen. She's done it all. I lost my place. But it was because you were here to supply all that. And I have to say thank you. Hannah is kind and compassionate. And she is the president of the freshman class at Middletown High School. But she has the very best strong leg, Elena. Playing soccer. She has, you can't believe it. You'll have to see it. And I want to again thank you for being an essential continuing part of her life. She is well prepared to serve God, her church, and the community.
Good morning. The church has always played an influential role in my life. The teachings of my faith come from years beginning in Sunday school and participating in church activities. From times when I was very young, I remember getting up early and getting excited to go to church. As I got older, I became more busy and wasn't able to be as active in my church community. Through confirmation, I feel I was able to get that part back of me. And though I'm not always present at church, I have my faith that follows me everywhere I go, ensuring me of God's presence in my life. Times in my life where I often feel God's presence is in times of need and wonder. God has a spiritual way of reassuring me throughout the day. I can get worried about things big or small, but I'm sure that if I turn to God, he is there to guide me. I just recently felt God's presence when I was overwhelmed with a number of different things. I'm not quite sure what it was or when it was exactly, but there was a certain point where I realized everything was going to be all right. Looking back at it, I'm sure that the presence of God was there during this occurrence. People who have shown me God are my parents, Paul and Stephanie Brody, my mentor, Susan Murphy, and grandmother, Deborah Brody. When I look at them, I see the resemblance of faith and remember what they have taught me about my faith. There are also stories that I've been told by my parents, families, and friends that make it obvious to me that God is always present when we need and support. There is also many times when I personally experienced the attendance of God. An event that first comes to mind was when I was in a car crash at a very young age and I was in the back seat and was very lucky to not have been injured at all. It was highly unlikely that I wouldn't have been injured, but I believe that with the protection of God and Him looking after me, I made it out of the wreck safely and unharmed. Growing up on Aquinic Island has subjected me to the natural beauty that surrounds this community. Every day I see the beauty, which to me is God. It is not always at the same spot. Different locations around the island demonstrate His glory and is constantly changing. I feel as if God is seen in different forms and ways that you may not realize it is God until after you have seen it. God to me is a leader, savior, and protector who is always there when I seem to need support in my life. God has also played a big role in my connection with my faith. Jesus has guided me in ways that make me question the purpose of my doings. From both Jesus and God, they have created the Holy Spirit, which drives me to accomplish and do my best in everything I attempt. They have both inspired me to be a good citizen, student, and best possible person I can be. I believe that by continuing my faith in them, following the Holy Spirit, and being a good person, I will satisfy God's wants for me as a believer. I'll continue my journey in faith in and out of community. On our day trip to Boston, I was able to get a firsthand experience and opportunity to share my belief in God. Spending the day at the Common Art Cathedral opened my eyes to new perspectives of faith and how it affects people. I am grateful to be able to witness and make this my goal to continue my journey by seeking insight from different communities and their opinions on faith. Through confirmation process, along with check-ins with my mentor, I was able to discover my favorite way of getting involved in worship was by acolyting and reading scripture. Getting involved deepened my connection with the Holy Spirit and brought me closer to God. Now as I reflect on my journey, I'm so grateful to have been in this church community. People and leaders of the church have made this adventure such an intriguing experience. I especially grew closer with my mentor, Susan Murphy. Even though our interactions were often short, whether it was a small conversation in person or over the phone, she was always there to help me. I also connected with my grandmother more often, which I was very glad about. Since last December, I've been working on learning more about the Holy Spirit, God, Jesus, and building my faith. This entire journey has taught me so much about myself and God, and I'm honored to be able to do it in such a great community of people.
It's a pleasure to introduce you to Dude Lisa Clarkson. She is a freshman at Middleton High School and is on the soccer team there. When I first met her, one of the first things I told her was how nervous I get standing up here. She said to me, "It'll be okay. I'll be with you." It's been a joy to be with her.
Who is God? The topic of religion and who and what to believe in has been a debate for centuries. But who you decide to pray to or look to have faith in should not be something that dictates your well-being. Throughout the years, my interpretation of God has changed. In 2023, I've seen God show up in so many different ways, especially through people. Both the Bible and God spread the same messages, which is leading with love, following the light of Christ, and treating your neighbors with kindness. When I see someone who might be doing the smallest act of kindness, but still impacts someone's day, I see that they believe in God, and my interpretation of God is shown through their act of kindness. In the past couple of years, God has been in my presence and has held my hand through a very challenging time in my life. As many of you know, I had a twin brother, but being in a family did not fit his image. But through the confirmation class, I've realized that even though he's not with us, he's still in my heart, and that God still loves him, which has helped me stay in the light. Without the support of our church families and being in and believing in God, recovering would have been much more painful. But recently, the clearest I've seen God has been in the past couple weeks. As many of you know, that there's been an ongoing war between Israel and Gaza, and from both sides, innocent people are suffering, but there are also a handful of people risking their lives to lead and protest, so someday their country will restore peace, and many citizens are risking their lives to help their neighbors, all because they have faith in who they believe in. This has helped me come to the realization that I can walk in God's presence and not be scared to be silenced or be killed. I hope with my confirmation today, I hope my journey with God grows and I continue to walk in Christ's path. And I hope my connections with their church grows more.
We invite to come forward the ones who wish to affirm their baptism by being confirmed. Please come on up and face the cross.
Do you desire to affirm the promises of your baptism and to confess your faith in God, whose love created you, in Christ, whose love redeemed you, and in the Holy Spirit, whose love sustains you? If so, please say, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Do you promise, through the grace of God, to seek to live as disciples of Jesus Christ, to follow where he leads you, to resist oppression in all its forms, to show love and to work for justice, and to witness as best as you are able to work an in word of Christ? If so, say, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Do you promise to participate in the life and the mission of Christ's church in this place and among these people, sharing regularly in worship of God and enlisting in the work of this church as it serves God and our community and our world? If so, please say, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
I invite you as a congregation to please stand and to say in unison our affirmation of faith. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our judge and our hope. In life, in death, and in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Please be seated.
Except for you. Now it's time for the laying of the hands. So I ask Hannah Birdie to go first and to kneel. We have cushions. Logan didn't get cushions, so this is good. And I ask for you to come on up, a few of you over here. And you can put your hands on her too. We ask for Hannah's family to come up and her mentors. And I ask those in your seat just to put your hand out in front of you so we could give her some wonderful prayers and vibration and good thoughts as we pray. Come on over. Come on. We're laying of the hands. And deacons, too. Yes. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant Hannah through the water of baptism. Nourish in her the power of your Holy Spirit that she may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her to live not for herself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
And I ask you to step up and let Delay, your turn now. And I ask Delay's family to come join us and her mentors. You can stay, family. Yep, we're just gonna keep adding. Come on up.
Yes, Barbara. Come on in, Barbara. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant, the Zule, through the water of baptism. Nourish her with the power of your Holy Spirit, that she may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her to live not for herself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
Kyle, it is your turn. I ask Kyle's family to join us in mentors. I can feel the love up here. Oh God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant Kyle through the water of baptism. Nourish in him the power of your Holy Spirit, that he may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him to live not for himself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
Elena. And Elena's family, please join us and her mentors. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant Elena through the water of baptism. Nourish in her the power of your Holy Spirit, that she may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that she has been moved to affirm her baptism. Help her to live not for herself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
Ben's family, please join us and his mentors. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant, Ben, through the water of baptism. Nourish him in the power of your Holy Spirit, so that he may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him to live not for himself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
Luke? And Luke's family, please stay and join us as mentors. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this servant Luke through the water of baptism. Nourish in him the power of the Holy Spirit, that he may serve you in the world.
We give you thanks that he has been moved to affirm his baptism. Help him to live not for himself, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves.
We ask you to look out to the congregation for this final blessing. You could stand on the first step. Almighty One, we ask you to surround these servants with your abundant love. Let them continue to hear your voice, feel your presence at the crossroads of life, see your light in the everyday, especially in the darkest hour. Remind them they are never alone. They are sacred and your beloved children. We ask for your blessing in this moment and the faith ahead, with your grace and power, and in the name of Christ Jesus. Amen.
I now invite you as a congregation to welcome these young people as printed in the bulletin. Let us, the members of United Congregational Church, express our welcome and affirm our mutual ministry in Christ.
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of Jesus Christ and on behalf of the Board of Deacons and the United Congregational Church, I extend to you the hand of Christian love.
Let us lift our hands in celebration for this wonderful day.
On behalf of the church, I want you to know how important this is to us. Now, life can be hard. We've seen that this morning. We see it on the news every day. And so to be able to celebrate your lives, your commitment, your faith, your many gifts, gives us hope. Thank you for being willing to stand here in this embarrassment, knowing that you are surrounded by love. Not only this congregation and your families who adore you, but by God. So with God's blessings, you may return to your seat. We turn now to that time in the service where we lift up to God our prayers. Let us come together as a community of faith. Good and holy God, we are so grateful for this day, a day when we have sought your love and grace. We are grateful for the lives of our young people who bring us hope with their fresh perspectives, their incredible energy, their many gifts. And we ask for your continued blessing upon each of their lives as they continue their journey of faith with you. May they always know of our unfailing love and devotion, as they make their way in this world. And may they bring the light of your love into the world, that more may know of your love and grace. Oh God, we give you thanks for the voices who cry out for something better, for a world more reflective of your vision. We lift our thanks too, inspiring God, for those who, even in the face of rising violence and indifference to common decency, use their voices to gift us with powerful wisdom. For those who give shape to our own feelings or to the common truths we hold dear. For those who find the courage to stand up against tyranny and hatred. May we be inspired by these agents of kindness and beauty and of change, so we may stand with them when the way is not always sure. Loving God, we thank you for your love and care for each of us. And you know the burdens that we carry in our hearts, as well as the names of those that we will lift up to you now. We ask that you surround them each with your loving presence. For Sarah Young and Megan, Karen's daughter. For my brother-in-law, Bob, and his family. Deborah, Sarah, Megan and Miles, Shoko, Nancy and Tom, Ginny and Bob, Tom, Rick, Martin, Barrett, Gigi and family, Celeste, David, Anne, Youngja, Janet, Barbara, Christian, Rose, Ben, Nicole, Bodie, Mary, Judy, Tom, Maggie and her family, Liz and Brian, Jeremy and his family, Shirley and Rick, Jill, Matthew, William, Josh, John, Loretta, and Marge, Carol, David, Paul, and all those who are experiencing financial woes, Tony, Sandra, Ella, the Cotta and Harbor families, caregivers and those for whom they care, for the people of Israel and the innocent people of Gaza, for family of friends being held in hostage in Gaza. Loving God, through the baptismal rains of your love, we ask that you hold each in your love, and to hear all our prayers, whether they find voice or not. And gather with us now as we offer the prayer that Jesus taught his followers, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This ministry touches many hearts. I've seen it every day. And it's only possible because of your support. Your time, your talent, and your gifts of love make a difference. And so with gratitude in our hearts, let us offer the gifts that we have brought to this church and its ministry, for this morning's offering will now be received. Please join me in the offering prayer. As we give ourselves and our offerings, we pray, O God, that they may reveal your love in such a way that many will respond. Awaken in us a love for you and for one another that is contagious. Remove from us all apathy, pretension, and greed, that we may grow in holiness and compassion, living joyously in communion with you. Amen.
seated. I don't know about you, but I think we need some more tissues in the pews. What a sacred and celebratory morning. I thank our visitors and our friends and everyone. This has just been a joyous, joyous morning. And in that spirit, we have some wonderful sweets and refreshments. And so I invite everyone to join us in the fellowship hall and have some cupcakes and other nourishments and congratulate our conference and their journey. And now for the benediction. Let us go forth into this new season of our lives, reaffirmed in faith and our commitment for the journey ahead. Let us go forth into growing and changing and living with a caring awareness for the world and all that is in it. Let us go forth with a sense of wonder and awe and curiosity, for the mystery of the Holy Spirit surrounds us always. Let us go with Jesus's commandments to love and with love in our hearts, for God's transformational power is found here in community. Go in peace, my friends. Amen.